declining stability of the system. What alarmed me the most was that the ability of the system to absorb shocks and disasters, to deal with climate change, to deal with overfishing, was diminishing. It could be a road of no return.
According to data collected by the United Nations, the number of fish species whose populations have crashed is growing year by year. Wurm and the other scientists have projected that if the current trends continue, the stocks of fish which we now eat will have collapsed by the middle of the century.
What we noticed was the curves, they were separating, the high and low diversity curves, but they were both dropping.
All the fish and invertebrates that we eat, that supply us with seafood, we found that by 2003, about one-third of them were in what we called collapsed state. Over the last 50 years, there was a very, very clear trend of year after year after year, more of these species were in that collapsed category.
They started very high, they kept dropping and dropping and dropping and dropping, and if you take those curves and you say, well, they're dropping, when are they going to hit zero? When are they going to drop down to the point where the fisheries that we're used to are no longer going to be possible? And those curves drop down and they hit zero about 2048.
This is not some horror scenario, it's a real possibility, and it's not rocket science, because if we're depleting one species after another, it's a finite resource, there will be a point in the future where we will run out if we don't change the way we treat this global resource.
Wurm and the others were criticized by their opponents for naming a precise date, but this was not the point they were making.
Whoever makes an interpolation makes it always assuming that things remain the same. And I would say that assuming that things remain the same, this prediction that we will have no fish in 50 years or so are essentially correct.
When the human population comes under real pressure on land, when we begin to have real problems from global warming, when we start running out of enough food to feed ourselves, we have just squandered one of the greatest resources that we've ever had on the planet, wild fish. That's what it means.